Jay Schreck, and if you know that mountain, then you know where I'm at. And that is Picket Post Mountain. That is Superior. That is the Apache Leap. And here we go. We're going to do our first e-bike adventure in Superior, Arizona. So I can't wait. I'm excited. I think it's going to be really cool. First time ever, e-bike adventures. And what an awesome day we're going to have. You'll get a little bit of everything. You'll get a little ride with me. You'll get a little talking. We're going to see historical stuff. We're going to see all kinds of different things today on this e-bike journey into history. Jay Schreck, Mad History E-Bike Adventures. Are you ready for an adventure? I sure am. There's where we're heading, folks, right there. Right here again is the ore tracks where these ore carts would have came from the mountain up top to the Silver King. Hopefully we'll make it up there today. And they would have grooved. Look at the mule where the steps, where the horseshoes or the mule shoes, I guess you would say, came through here. And look at the grooves in this thing. It's absolutely unbelievable that it ground straight through solid rock. Look at that track. It's incredible. This was a boom for a few years. It didn't last that long like most of them did. And when the silver ran out and or the price of silver went down, it adjusted the market. But man, when they were on, they were on. So let's take this old bike tricks, move on down the road. So let's head on out of here. Get on down the trail and continue this adventure. So we didn't go to the last road. That's what you got to make sure you do, is go to the last road. Now all those ore wagons would have came this way. Now, the cavalry spent a lot of time down here as well. So that is Picket Post is Fort Picket Post. So let's get in here and take a ride down here. See how much water is going through the creek. Now you'll see there's a good reason why nobody is driving down here, right? Except us. Now there might be water in the creek. That's the only thing that I'm worried about. And we'll get through it. Once we get through it, then we'll be home free. And there, look what we got. Somebody built a nice, look at there. That's pretty nice. We're gonna take that. And isn't that nice? Appreciate whoever did that work. I got my foot just solid wet. I can't believe I did that. Should have just walked it. I should have just rode through it. But I didn't, so we're gonna go on up this hill. Should have just rode on through. You guys do it. How rough is this? This is getting it right here. I don't remember this hill being there. We're gonna show you, if you got a place you're not comfortable with riding, for example, take this thing down to zero, hold in the negative button, and then let it walk, okay? So it will walk up this hill. So that's an advantage. If you get to a place you don't feel comfortable, you can't turn around. This is rough now, I'm telling you. I might even walk this down. But look what it'll do. You're not pushing. It's pushing itself up the hill. So whatever gear you've got, you just walk it up. There it is. A few years since I've been up here, and I didn't remember that being that steep. But when you're hiking, you don't think about it. You just hike it. I'm not going down that one. But thanks for. I'm going down, but not on this. Where we're going is an area that. There's only two or three of these in the Southwest. This is what they call Apache Tears. Now the story about Apache Tears is, if you see that peak over there, the story is 25 Apache warriors leaped off that. And when the bodies, when the women came for the bodies, they shed tears, and they say that that tear became these black stones you'll see in this area. Now, the reason this is mined is because they use this in plant food. So that's why this was mined, is because it was in plant food. Cool. Really incredible through here. See if we can get through there as well. This has been picked over so good. Used to be you could walk through here anywhere and see this black glass that the ancients used to build arrowheads and knives out of it. It's razor sharp. And it'll be embedded in this wall. And then you'll pick it out with a pick. And it's an interesting deal. Look at this canyon. Tell me this isn't spectacular. Weaver's Needle, Arizona Trail, which goes all the way from Mexico into the border. See the trail down below? Hopefully you guys can see that. Look at this. Is this just beautiful or what? Just gorgeous. See me huffing and puffing a little bit. I'm still a little winded. So let's take a look. Check that battery one more time. I tell you what, again, there's an e-bike company out there that wants to see how tough their bikes are, then send them to me. Because if you can last this, you can last anywhere. Well, it's funny how you don't remember how steep something is when you hike it, but you sure remember how steep it is. You know, it's more rough than steep. I shouldn't say that because you might get the different opinion. you know, because coming down might be simple. It's definitely rough, though. Oh, that would have been nice into the cactus. That's something that's probably going to happen that I don't want to talk about. Well, I also told myself I wasn't going to be dumb today. I'm starting off that way. Starting to power this dog on. Now I'm going to do something we've never done. We've never really looked. So now the hike that we just did, and I say hike because we didn't hike it, we e-biked it. That would have taken you, this is an all-day deal. So that's what's funny about this is that this would have been all day. But it's not all day to us. We're going to run this whole mountain in about an hour, and we'll be at the Silver King Mine in 30 minutes, and most people won't be able to get there. They won't be able to get there because they're walking. And I'm telling you what, it sure makes it nice. Okay, look at that view. See, if you look on the other side, you can see that there's Park's truck. Truck's on the other side of that airport landing field you see right there. And that's where we were down below. Hydrate. Don't die. Hydrate, don't die. I'm just stunned how many people coming down here. So what's the one thing I'm learning? Probably take 2-3 pounds of pressure out of the tires. Definitely 2-3 pounds out of the tires. Get this bike through here this time. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna walk the bike through the water this time, like I should have done last time. Wasn't that easy and nice. Jump back on. Motor out of the motor. Get myself in a low gear. Let's go the hard way out. What do you say? Is that something or what? I'm just in awe of this bike. What it'll do. I think I'll sit here. This is not a road or a trail. I don't know what it is. Why wouldn't they just block it off? It's not a road or a trail. Well, I say one thing, it's pretty dang cool down here. Look at that. Well, I think what we'll do is we'll go back to the truck and we'll get prepared to head across the highway to see what's over there. Make sure I got enough batteries.